Johnson College and Glyn School. Your lineup for Wright Robinson College at 1, PJ Vorney. At 2, Kieran Lilly. At 3, Josh Guyon. At 4, Shea Fitzsimon. At 5, Simon Pilas. At 6, Toby Harley. At 7, Joel Mafolo. At 8, Mackenzie Yates. At 9, Kaya Smart Powell. At 10, Cameron Duff.
And it's a very good morning from me, Johnny Bryan. Welcome to the Hawthorns for the third day of the ESFA PlayStation FC Schools Cup Finals for 2022. Our opening fixture is a South v North affair between the Glyn School of Epsom against Wright Robinson College of Manchester. This under 15 B team Schools Cup Final, 9:30 kickoff, live here from the Hawthorns, the home of West Brom FC. So our referee, Topper Parks, ably assisted by the man between the sticks, Ethan McCorgan, George Compton, Connor Stevens, Zach Harris, Wes Brad, Oliver Buckley and Ryan Wishart are the starting 11 for the Glyn School of Epsom. First of three finals for Wright Robinson College today. PJ Voorhees in the sticks. Keenan Lilly, Josh Guyon, Shea Fitzsimmons is the captain. Seisman Pilas, number 5, Toby Harley, 6. Joel Mafolo, 7. Mackenzie Yates, Kia Smart Powell, Cameron Duff and Liam Wood make up their starting 11. With Kieran G, the manager, on the sidelines. Substitutes for both the sides. Keep your eye on Finn O'Sullivan, who's their substitute goalkeeper and also plays outfield as well for the Glyn School. And just three substitutes for Wright Robinson College here for this under-15s B team final. Our man in the middle is Trevor Parks. School and Wright Robinson College get ready to kick off this opening fixture. So everybody waiting with bated breath as we get underway. And speaking of people who have just arrived through bated breath as well, Deli Adebola alongside me today. Deli, you just ran up the stairs. I know the M5 was a little bit busy this morning.
Yeah, just got here. I haven't even had breakfast yet.
No doubt, we'll find a bacon butty for you somewhere nearby. So it will be Wright Robinson College kicking off. Going from left to right here at the Hawthorns on this breezy morning. You wouldn't have thought it's the end of May. And it is Wright Robinson College who are looking to get on the ascendancy from the off. Mackenzie Yates with the throw. Sending it back to Josh Guyon. Guyon pumped it forward. And there are referee's flag already up for an offside. How's your morning?
Oh, busy. Now, getting up, looking forward to a day's full of football here as well. The quality was really good on Monday as well, so I know yesterday there's been sort of I heard about some of the quality on show here today, so looking forward to today.
Yes, five finals we're bringing you throughout the day. This is the first of the five, and the crowd in good voice for early morning. As Wes Brown of New School takes a throw.
Across really well there, just anticipated the bounce of the ball and stepped across the attacker. I'd say the pace of the game, it's been a slower start than what you saw on some of the fixtures previous days, but I think there's a lot more. you know, the narrow pitches of the younger ages.
So both sides full of energy and full of vigour in the opening exchanges.
Strange seeing him taking a goal kick there. I think Blues weren't offering any sort of pressure.
The pressure coming in, and now a referee, Trevor Parks, not interested in the appeals. From Liam Wood.
I was going to say, when you get to finals, you tend to sort of, you see the kicking, they're not trying to play out from the back early doors. No chances early on. I think there's one centre-half there willing to take that chance, but I think, you know, you've come this far, just getting that, not conceding early on, and maybe if you can nick a goal, it seems to be a bit more direct for the early exchanges.
40 minutes and a half, just to remind you, at this level. As Chowdhury pumps it upfield. Instead, it's taken by Cameron Duff. On the right, Robinson, number two, Kieran Lilly. So he can see the throw, good defending.
Yeah, Kieran was going to take everything with him there, wasn't he? It's like a full-blooded challenge there, but, you know, very competitive early in. Plenty of regression in the play.
No doubt, extra portion for breakfast this morning for young Kieran. Throw coming in for the Glyn score. Should reflect on, but at last it's a shot coming in from Wes Brown, and goes to ground, just nursing his back, but he seems okay.
Yeah, I mean, he was brave there from Wes. There was boots flying all over the place. He was determined to get a shot off, and unfortunately he's paid for it, but as any sort of, if you want to score a goal, you've got to put your body on the line at times. They haven't anticipated the bounce there. It's a good feat.
Mafolo dispossessed by Brown. Now off to the races with McLaughlin. Lilly though to pick up the scraps. Loose possession there from number 9 Ryan Wishart of Glyn School.
Interesting matchup over there on that side. Lilly seems to have a lot of pace. I'm not sure if the ball in behind down that flank is the key, but balls into feet, like, you know, the number 9 seems pretty competent.
Mm-hmm. Indeed the case. Connor Stevens to try and clear. Instead, finds Zach Harris. Harris goes out on the right hand side. This is Chowdhury.
You want the blue on this left side to pull wide to give him an option to play out the other direction. Seems to be content playing that high line, don't we? In possession.
Dispossessed, I think, 8-on-8. By Brown.
Play is very congested at the moment, isn't it? You know, both sides, like I said, lots of energy. Cup final. We're just waiting for the game to settle a little bit, so both sides have done really well footballing.
Yeah, there's a little bit scrappy and messy at the beginning there. The formation's not exactly keeping to tact in this first 5-6 minutes, as you said, Delhi, but alas, we still have a game on. Thornburn is offside.
The Blues seem to have willing runners, you know, to go down the flanks, and it is a good tactic by stretching the Reds. Of Robinson College, it creates space for the midfield and defence, so it might be just a tactic, get them turned early on, first 5-10 minutes, and then get down in place. But at the moment, they're turning every time they get it.
Simmons downfield. Reflected by Freddie Howard. He spins this one upfield, doesn't get past halfway. Instead, it will be take 2 for the Glyn score to try and clear. trying to be sent forward to Wishart. And Wishart, with a contest against Lilly, still retains possession and lays it off to McLaughlin. McLaughlin, though, loses out. And now it's a midfield battle that has been won by Wright Robinson College, and Liam Wood is off and running. He's on this left-hand side. Wood loses out again. Now Glyn School trying to find a counter-attack. Instead, it finds Pilas of Wright Robinson College, and it will be a throw.
You know, a little bit more time on it there. There's a couple of people trying to put on the foot on the ball and create something. Both sides have still got plenty of numbers behind the ball, so it's really difficult to find that space in midfield and defence. It's very, very packed.
So just 7 minutes down so far.
15 for Glyn School is trying to sort of release himself out wide and create space for everyone else, but everyone else is, you could almost put them in a quarter of the pitch over there, you know. It's very congested, but until someone does release themselves out wide and put for it, it's going to remain like this.
Wishart wins the throw. Crowd in good voice this morning down below.
Yeah, seem to have brought quite a few. I'm not sure who they're supporting there. Trying to hear out who it is, but definitely making lots of noise.
Indeed they are. So Glyn School on the front foot inside the Wright Robinson half. Cleared by Fitzsimmons, the captain. Shot coming right into the hands of Voorhees in the goal. To win for our first clear-cut chance.
You couldn't really class that one either, unfortunately. But, you know, if he has a go, the pitch is slippy as well. He kept it low.
This is Buckley. The shot across. Still in play. Chance here for Glyn School, but excellent defending to clear the danger. But for how long? Good opportunity there for Glyn School.
Yeah, down that right flank, Wishart is causing lots of problems, more with his energy and his running in behind. That opportunity, he's managed to get across for his partner, who just slightly too high for him to do anything really. But yeah, got another good opportunity, but still no clear-cut shot on goal.
Zach Harris just cleared in the danger there. There's a replay of what we've just seen.
Yeah, he's picked up a good position. And then the cross comes in, but just, you know what, just one of those, just out of his range. But maybe if he would have changed the angle of his approach there, he could have covered more of the six-yard box.
Towards downfield, and now an opportunity comes here for Leo Thorburn. Thorburn one-on-one with the keeper. The shoulder, the scoring! Is it there? Is it there? Goal! Great defending! Fitzsimmons clears the lines and keeps it 0-0.
Oh, what a great ball. I think the defence were caught flat-footed there, played a high line, couldn't make the clearance. It's left the number seven free up, Thorburn, one-on-one with the goalkeeper, and he's done everything right there. Keeper's done well to get his foot out and slow the sort of advance towards goal of the ball, but ultimately defenders got back to clear.
The Wright Robinson College captain keeps it 0-0.
Possibly could have took his shot a little bit earlier, but you know, it's ifs and maybes there.
Cross comes in again. Thorburn needs to add another couple of feet or to his height to have a chance to get to that one.
Yeah, it's maybe his movement. He's attacking his balls a little bit straight, a little bit of an angle, pull out wide, and then run across the goal instead of running straight in. He might be able to sort of connect with a little bit more from these crosses. And that time to find things run out.
Wishart retains possession inside the centre circle. Finds Wes Brown. Brown under pressure by Mafolo. He keeps the ball in hand, but only momentarily. charged upfield and finds Liam Wood. Wood, good defending from Glyn School. And then number four, Connor Stevens. That is his many way a few yards. And when that chance to clear, finds his man, does well.
Now we're starting to see a little bit of controlled possession.
Ball going forward, Wishart, not going to win that race. Instead, it's been won by Voorhees in the Wright Robinson goal. Ball still kept in play though, picked up by Mafolo. Josh Guyon. Guyon loses out that particular battle, and Brown is off to the races once more. Brown needed a good tackle from Mackenzie Yates.
See the confidence coming out from Glyn School now. You know, they've strung a couple of passes together and all of a sudden start to settle and start to connect. And the advancing of the pitch with controlled possession, which will create more chances, ultimately create more chances for them.
Ball into the mixer. Shot coming in from Oliver Buckley. Just wide of the upright.
Yeah, good play. Tried to pick out his man on the far post. And it looks like off a defensive clearance, Brockley's picked up. He decided to take it on, that's brave. And wasn't far off, to be fair. Kept the shot low. Bit of trouble to keep it if it was on target.
Fitzsimmons. Goal kick duty for Wright Robinson College. Finds the men in red. And needs Wes Brown to find touch to stop the advance.
I think Wes, the keeper was on for Wes to play it back, but I don't think anyone's taking chances here.
Duff. Into the 18 yards, but Glyn School the ones with their tails up. Fitzsimmons with the captain's performance so far, but loses out that little battle. And in blue have it forward. Picked up this time though by Smart Powell. Cameron Duff looking for options. He may have just found one, but he's offside.
There's a delightful little ball in there. I think, is it Johnson? Was slightly offside, but it was perfect. He took the first good touch and would have been an excellent opportunity for him. But he's just got to watch that line. I think Blues of Glyn School had pushed up slightly, and he didn't sort of.
Fitzsimmons with the head. Chowdhury. Simmons with the header.
Good by Chowdhury. He's probably starting to pull the strings a little bit.
Chowdhury nudges that forward, but that's offside. I think they could tell that one from Molyneux, never mind the Hawthorns.
You can see Chowdhury has found himself in a little bit of space there, hasn't panicked. He just looks far more comfortable and starting to try and pick out plays with some good forward passes.
Raoul Mungo is coming onto the field. Indeed the case. So early change for the Glyn School.
He's taking an early position out on this left wing. Sure, maybe to give everyone a chance. This roll on roll, all off substitutions, isn't it?
ball goes forward straight into the arms of Howard. Howard starts from the deep with Connor Stevens. Stevens forward this time, Oliver Buckley. Buckley needs to find some space, trying to make something of it, but instead finds a wall of red.
Love that from Glyn score. Starting to get the ball down and pass it around. And
we've seen that happen many a time before.
Yeah, with the skiddy surface as well, I'm quite surprised. On that occasion, it didn't just skid through.
Mungur making an impact from the start. Buckley, and this is the man, the substitute, Mungur, to open the scoring! Oh. And once again,
excellent.
The door is shut.
Yeah, excellent take from Mungur. He's showing his quick footwork around the halfway line. Good little passing movement. And then it's that reverse ball back in for his run to go through one-on-one with the goalkeeper. Again, gone through the goalkeeper's legs, but it's that number four again. Shea Fitzsimmons, it's a clear danger.
Throw in into the box. Cleared by Wright Robinson College. We've been under the cosh in this first period, this first half. Glyn School have been in the ascendancy, but have had no reward so far.
Yeah, Glyn School are much more prepared to get it down and pass it around. I think until Robinson College can do the same or find the confidence to do the same, it's going to be a little bit scrappy, but it doesn't mean that the result's going to be end of this one-way result. It's about creating chances.
Brown and Chelby having a quick chat to survey their options. And Brown is having a long run for this. He's a la Paul Forbin in rugby. This type of run for a kick, but it's got it down into the corner. Just to run out of play.
That was unfortunate, but, you know, like at the back there, they had, I think there was about four defenders on one attacker. It might have been better taking it short and just building their way forward, which they've started to do a lot more, but that was a perfect opportunity for them to have a little bit more controlled possession.
The band tuning up below us. Fine voice for an early morning. Fitzsimmons sends downfield. Toby Harley. Zach Harris. And loose from Wright Robinson, but they have a chance to get into the box here, and they may just do so with smart Powell. Powell sends it across. No option there found. Liam Wood. Good tackle, adjudged, and Glyn School will look to clear through Connor Stevens. Connor Stevens spins to Oliver Buckley. Buckley, pass not on this occasion, the door is shut. Smart Powell. Mafolo, into the box. Rise up hand ball. And indeed, our referee spotted that outside the box. And it will be a free kick given here to Wright Robinson College, and a good attacking opportunity.
Yeah, I think Robinson College, in the last couple of minutes, have upped their game a little bit, managed to string a couple of passes together and built up really well down this right flank. The crosses that have come in haven't really troubled Glyn School, but, you know, they're making inroads and can take some confidence from that. A really good opportunity here on the edge of the box.
Smart Powell. Options at the back post. And a gap at the back post as well. He decides to go himself. And not a bad effort.
from the angle we're in, you can see the swerve. It just took a couple of dips and a little bit of movement there. It's a good strike. Ultimately, didn't dip enough to nestle in the goal, but.
So we're halfway through this first half, still no score. Kenzie Yates.
A lot more space for the players, though. Both sides finding more space to work in after frenetic early exchanges.
A chance to put in school under pressure here for the team in red. They've had it much the wrong way in these first 20 minutes. Shot coming in, distance, and it needed to be saved from Cameron Duff. Freddie Howard needed to put the save in. First corner coming in for Wright Robinson College.
Yeah, I'm not sure if Cameron's tried to catch that, which is always a dangerous option, especially when the shot's on target like that. He's managed to get enough on it to deflect it wide.
So Yates on corner duty. Bad effort it is as well. Needs to be cleared. And if so, and now a race is on here to collect the scraps. Guillen heads forward to his opposite number, Chowdhury. Crossfield ball, headed away by Pilas. This is McNicholas. Buckley. Chowdhury into the box. Overhead kick coming in from Ryan Wishart. Great effort.
Good play from Glyn School there. Again, about four or five passes before the ball goes into the box. Speculative overhead kick, but, you know, I've seen him go in.
Cameron Duff. Up to go sideways. Instead, dispossessed. Lilly. Guyan. His options is to go in field, and the attack is closed. Zach Harris looks to clear but hasn't, and an opportunity coming in for Toby Harley
there. Zach Harris was brave to try and I think he's trying to dribble his way out there. He's got caught. Once that first tackle comes in, he's got to try and release it somewhere else. It's Toby Harris is waiting for that opportunity. Manson nick it off his toes there, all opened up for him. The shot was just a little bit too high and wide. More of an even game at the moment, isn't it?
Well, very much so. We've played just over 25 minutes and it's very much even Stevens. Both sides now creating chances. No reward so far. Just looking at the results we've seen in the past few days, we've had a few 7-1s, a 5-1, 4-3. This match has been more of a war of attrition so far. Plenty of contact, this is great to see.
Didn't see a lot of the challenge initially, but obviously it's a scuffle afterwards.
Fitzsimmons.
Opportunity for Robinson College to launch this into the box. Chiefs.
Not in the box it was, but. No reward from it, though. It's still an even game. Yates. Towards Compton, under pressure from Smart Powell, and Smart Powell won that particular battle.
Small Powell just he's gone in full blooded there. Didn't really get near the ball. I was going to say good foul. It's not, you can't really say that. It's not a good foul, but he stopped the play.
Fitzsimmons. Eyes up the targets. Says that goes himself. Not a bad effort.
He's got a good strike on him, Fitzsimmons. He's just a little bit lower. I think that might have troubled the keeper. It's a long distance to shoot from, but he's definitely got confidence in his ability there. Backed himself.
Well, I've seen him go in the past. That is for certain. Wissart. Going to dance his way forward instead. Finds Toby Harley.
Like Wissart, he's had loads of energy. He's been causing problems out in that front four game.
Well, defending from the floor is never the first time we've seen that from number six, Zach Harris. Again, headers and volleys, it seems.
Just needed Toby Harley to slow the game down, and then I've also liked that player on the ball there, Chowdhury. And if he gets it, he seems calm and collected in possession.
Josh Guy going to no man's land. We've got a man down here.
On his knee. Looks, hopefully, this isn't too serious, but there was a bit of a nasty collision. See that. Hopefully it's just a little, it's jaw, it's not too serious.
Yeah, that was
holding it in a way that looked pretty worrying, but it seems to have settled down after the initial collision.
Yeah, it just doesn't seem to be like a clash of knees, as it were. As I say, we've got a good crowd in this morning.
All happy to see themselves on the television in the far corner over there.
Yes, absolutely.
Highlight of the day for them.
As I said, we're at Wright Robinson College. I think they might have brought a bus full here because they've got three teams here today. So it's a day out for that college.
Yeah. Fair play to them to have so many teams in the finals. If all the teams would have battled their way through numerous rounds to get here. And, to have three teams in the final just shows just how strong a footballing school they are.
Absolutely, they got the under 14 girls play Surbiton High School in our next match, and then the following match after that, the under 13 B team cup is against Tunbridge Wells Grammar School. So Wright Robinson School, they got the pick of the first three games today. So. No doubt that school, I hope they got all of them got the morning off. Or it could be a day off, in fact, because it's up till 3 o'clock this afternoon.
I can name the competition Wright Robinson College Cup.
Well, Wright Robinson College Day here then, in the Hawthorns. The substitution, I think, has been made.
It seems okay. It's got an ice pack on there. Sure, in a couple of minutes he'll be raring to get back on.
So 10 minutes to go and a little bit of change to add to that. As a substitution coming onto the pitch, number 16, Ethan Hedger is. Coming onto the field. There's Zach Harris, who will go and receive some more treatment. Yeah. the tackle there from Munger. It's caused a little bit of havoc since he's come onto the field.
Good pressing there as well. So good. Trying to play out from the back here.
Wishart. Good layoff. Try and find number 12, McLaughlin.
Robertson College there. So she likes to play it. So the following forwards.
Good shot.
So frustrating for them. There's no ball boys today. So they're having to jump over the hoardings to get the ball each time. So hopefully it doesn't go too far right into the
into the seats.
A lot of them.
Never used to get this in your day, did it? There'll always be someone in the crowd to launch it back at you.
Well, it's a fantastic opportunity for these young lads to play on a first team pitch here.
Absolutely. You know,
got a good atmosphere and brought plenty of fans with them.
Yeah, the first time I've been to this great ground, which I believe one of the great quiz questions, the highest above sea level in this country. And there's no doubt with the reason why we're wearing jackets at the end of May in the gantry.
Bad news is it's cold all over Birmingham. I woke up and the other side in Solihull to rain. So I can't quite see if it's raining here, but it's not as bad as where I was.
No, it was delightful in North Wales this morning on my way down. Here we go. Opportunity arises for like Robinson College.
This goal rolls up plenty of numbers at the back there, so it's really difficult for Robinson College to break through. So I think they're playing a back four with two holding midfielders, which, you know, for the amount of possession they've had, is really good.
Harley. Straight into the arms. Freddie Howard.
I think Robinson College have got willing runners all over the place. You know, it's a different. They probably need to have that defensive stability there, because I think any less in numbers.
Smart Powell. There's one option in the box for Liam Wood. Doesn't have the opportunity to get there.
Stevens.
Yates with a shot from distance. Wide of the upright. Still 0-0.
Again, Robertson College not afraid to take those long shots. There, Yates found the pocket of space, but didn't really have enough space to really attack that. It was more one step and a more speculative lob.
Yeah. Harley doesn't nudge it forward to Cameron Duff, but instead loses out to Oliver Buckley, who's now off and running. Buckley spins, finds Chowdhury, back to Buckley. Buckley with a loose touch has now been dispossessed. Smart Powell now looking to pick up the scraps. Loose pass from the right Robinson College number 9. Mackenzie Yates there to pick it up. Instead, it's going to be Hedger to try and clear his lines. Does not do so. Toby Harley's the man there, but he's got two men in blue against him, and he went down a cul-de-sac no way through.
Yeah, I mean, he's done ever so well to protect the ball. He's won it back and then managed it really well, got his arms out, protected it, and then tried to dig out that cross, but just not enough power to sort of send it past the goalkeeper for anything that could trouble this Glyn school defence.
At Robinson College once again. Looking to try and open their account. Mafolo could be there, but instead picked up by Freddie Howard.
I think if McFowler would have gambled on that a bit more, he might have had some reward.
Mungo. Just possessed by Fitzsimmons, who has been like a rock in the Wright Robinson College defence. And it finds a superb pass to Liam Wood, but he just couldn't get on the end of it.
Liam didn't take that touch. The way the ball skidding off the surface, you know, he had to get something on it early on in that move to stop it from going out of play.
So about 3 minutes to go for stoppage time, so we might have a couple of minutes as well.
There's one injury there.
And we've had a couple of substitutions, so you know, give me 2 minutes of stoppage time to be added here, so it's plenty of time to try and one of these sides to open that account. In this final, there's been a nip and tuck affair. Both sides having chances.
Back over there. Obviously, Robertson College causing problems from the throw-in. Glyn School, I think. It's clearance gone wrong. He's just managed to ease it out for corner kick. Opportunity for the college to send more players forward. They've got plenty of players back.
Yeah, it's four men outside the 18-yard line. As Mackenzie Yates drives this one in, picked up by Howard in the goal.
Good hands by Howard. He's going to try and catch. There's no one up there.
It's Simmons. Smart Paul. With a shot from distance. And a shot on target nonetheless.
Didn't trouble Howard. So, show save there. He caught one of those. It was comfortable. Got across. Moved his feet, got across. Good hands. No danger.
One for the cameras, no doubt. That'll be put up on his social media. That is for sure. The ball tries to go forward for Mongo. Josh Guyon is there to stop the Glyn School attack. And once again, the Wright Robinson number three tries to send downfield, but instead he's been picked up here by Wishart. Wishart into the box, and he's still there, Wishart. Vorhey in the goal, picks up, but a couple of appeals, but our referee, Topper Parks, not interested this morning.
So, industrious running again from Wishart, and shown really good close control. He's managed to weave himself into the box, but just lacked the strength to sort of steady himself and pick out one of his teammates with Talon Cross. Some severe pressure there, though.
So, as we reach the dying embers of this first half, our free kick inside their own half as we hit stoppage time. Our fourth official about to put up how many minutes? Probably 2 minutes will be added on here for Glyn School. Should they want to try and pick up something toward the end of this half? Wishart into the box. Oh, good save.
Again, Wishart in the heart of the action. Good play. Nice build up from Chowdhury there. A bit of link up play. And just release Wishart. And across, unfortunately, the keeper's able to come out and collect relatively easy.
Indeed, that is the case. 2 minutes to be added in this first half. Entertaining first half, nonetheless. Even though the scoreline doesn't reflect it.
Both teams have had their moments.
Indeed. Fitzsimmons will send the ball to his keeper and move to slow the game down for the last minute or so as we approach the break.
Yeah, seems to be no push to take this, does he? Again, there's no real pressure from Glyn School, opportunity for Robertson College to run this out. Got a good kick on him, sort of higher up the pitch, but more dangerous. This will be. tackle from Chowdhury was a little bit late, but referee didn't see too much to pull it back about.
Very briefly, Delhi, if you're the managers here at half-time, what would you be saying to you, both sides?
Both sides, just take a little bit of care with that final ball. They're getting up the pitch relatively well, getting into good areas, but I think it's just that final ball to make sure of the goal is what's letting both sides down.
Well, one final chance here to come here for Wright Robinson College. Fitzsimmons to put this one into the mixer. Didn't get past the first man. And our referee, Trevor Parks, will blow for the break. Entertaining first half, no goals, but great endeavour from both sides. At the break, it is the Glyn School nil, Wright Robinson College nil. Have a look at what we've seen so far. Some great endeavour in this first half from both of these teams.
You see Oliver Buckley with a cross.
This is Leo Thornburn at the early part.
A great run by Thornburn. He was clean one-on-one with the goalkeeper. Could have took it a little bit earlier, but still good work. He's waited, drawn the keeper out, and then probably just on the edge of the box, he could have slid it back. But then on the other side, Shaford Simon, great following up, just to stop that from going in. Great little move there. Number 10, Buckley's reverse pass into the 11, Munger. And again, there's Fitzsimmons to clear the danger. Smart power, free kick on the edge of the box, really good area. Good connection, but couldn't quite find the finish. This is Cameron Duff testing Glyn School's Freddie Howard. Again, Shaford Simmons doesn't lack confidence. Good strike.
He's been very impressive in this first half, it must be said. And that was a decent save from Freddie Howard. One for his social media, that is no doubt. But we are goalless at the break. A chance for everybody to get some refreshments and a cup of tea, and that's what me and Delhi are going to do right now. At the break, Glyn School nil, Wright Robinson College nil. So very warm welcome back. I hope you've had refreshments. Myself and Delhi both have. We've ran down to the director's lounge to get a cup of tea and a cup of coffee, and now we're back and ready to go. And as is Glyn School, we've made a substitution. Leo Thornburn coming back onto the field.
Much needed cup of tea, by the way.
So 0-0 at the break. As you mentioned, Delhi, before we broke for half-time, managers, you would have thought, would have said, lads, great with what we've seen so far for two-thirds of the play. Last third just needed a little bit of TLC.
Yeah, no, definitely. Both sides have defended well. Glyn School have found pockets, and I've actually had two one-on-one situations. So they've managed to break lines, but it's just that final ball, the final finish, I'd say more from Robertson College that's missing.
So it is Glyn School going from left to right on your screen. And as an early opportunity brings up for Mafolo, instead given away and gifted to Wes Brown on the left-hand side. Brown, Josh again with a loose touch, but still picked up by Shea Fitzsimmons, the captain. Now, right Robinson College, nudging it forward for Liam Wood to chase. Kenzie Yates and Chowdhury in a battle. Yates picks up left boot, stopped by Connor Stevens. Stevens is nudged upfield, intercepted by Pilas, who sends it to touch onto the halfway line. Just mind you, 40 minutes each way in this competition, and myself and Delhi will be keeping my eyes on the 22 lads on the field, and we'll be nominating two players from each side for a Twitter poll for the player of the match. You're welcome to submit your votes on Twitter. We'll get that up around 15 minutes towards the end of the game. In the meantime, cross coming across the field from number 11, Mungo, who's caused some problems since he's come onto the field.
He's looked neat and tidy in possession, always willing to take people on. And then, like you said, it was that one-on-one situation he got into in the first half. Couldn't finish it off, but I'm sure he'll be, raring to make amends for the second half. He's got the pace to go in behind.
Fitzsimmons telling his players to go forward. Mafolo. His right wing. He's looking for an option. Says he's two blue shirts. Got to go back from whence he came to the smart Powell. Powell opens up for the shots and just goes over the bar.
Mafolo and Powell, the longer the game goes, the more space they're getting, the more into the game they're coming. Good little bit of link-up play there. Mafolo down the wing, comes inside, plays into Powell. Nice little turn, faces up. There's no pressure on the ball, so again, decides to have a shot. And unfortunately, doesn't hit the target with it, but again, good play. Having a solid game as well.
Indeed.
Yeah. Next to Pilas, sorry. Next to Fitzsimmons, the two of them have been pretty solid.
Pilas, once again. Walk at the back at the minute. Ball just kept out of play, and a good endeavour there from Mungo, who may have just spotted a little opening.
Yeah, relief was a bit like, should never just let that roll out of play. You've got to make sure you go and see it out. Mungo didn't give up on it.
Yeah, never give the opportunity. We've seen that happen many, many times before. Pilas with the arrows from the touch line. Loses this little battle. It's picked up by Thornburn. Thornburg. Makes there from Munger. Yeah, Munger, and he still collects. 11 on 11, and it's the Blues who win the battle. Munger, not this time, doesn't get past Mackenzie Yates, but this time he does get past Kieran Lilly. Munger with the cross, and Pilas sees it out for the first corner of the second half.
Now he's trying to lift that into his strike partner there. He was trying to cross it a little bit more delicate, but just didn't get enough purchase on and enough height to clear that first defender, Pilas. To keep us stopping from coming out and claiming this.
Oliver Buckley. Launches in, keeping it in no man's land.
Oh. Tactics seem to work. Managed to get ahead of him, well, just off target from Connor Stevens there. So we're really, really close. Good cross. Keep prevented from coming out and claiming it. Left Connor Stevens with a free header, just couldn't direct the control.
It's Marpol. Good Simmons. And this one. What is number 11 on goal. Picked up by Cameron Duff. Duff has found a gap. Door shot by Hedger. Cloppen. Mongol.
Final pass was left out. Sloppy in a really good area. He's lifted it to his team partners. Ended up with getting it to the ball. So punch pass into his feet. He might have been able to carry on that move.
Buckley, and going to ground, he's on his feet straight away.
I'm not sure what he's arguing about. It was a clear foul.
So attacking opportunity coming in for Glyn School. Distance, wide of the post.
Yeah, he's put it into a good area. It was a shot, but it's still in a good area. And if you have a couple of players gambling on that, you never know what happens. But everyone seemed to stand and watch and admire the shot instead of following that in, really. Defenders were on the back feet as well. Didn't see any defenders there trying to clear. So any blue gambling on that effort might have found some joy.
But Simmons restarts. Oh, Hedger, chance, goal.
What a finish.
Smart ball. Superb.
Yeah, of the two sides, you'd have to say Glyn School with the better keep possession and move the ball around. But what you've got with Robinson College is energy, pace, skill. And you can see the first time that he's gone through on goal there, he's finished emphatically. What a fantastic finish by the young lad.
We're talking through it, Deli. I think it caught a lot of us off guard, this one.
Yeah, I mean, it seems an innocuous ball in. Should have been cleared by Glyn College defender, but Powell's just gambled on it. And made the most of it, the first to react. Gambled, got there ahead of the defender, and then, you know, he's took his eyes away from the ball and just lifted it over the goalkeeper.
So it is the opening goal of this third day of this PlayStation FC Schools Cup Finals. Key Smart Powell of Wright Robinson College in Manchester, opening the account here on day three. And now they have their tails up. And a follow.
Right, they've been building from about 10 minutes before half time, and they've definitely taken the edge in this game. Hasn't been a lot of quality with the balls that have gone into the forwards, but you know, they're making the most of it. The forwards are willing runners and definitely making the most of the opportunities. Calgary. There's always going to be a problem. Glyn College, even though they are trying to pass play out and the more composed of the two teams, just got too many players behind the ball. Not a lot of options ahead of the ball for them.
When you mentioned players behind the ball, I'm guessing we are at the Hawthorns. It's the home of the 1-0 win.
I can't get involved in that. No comment. But you're right.
There's been many a time in my coupon on a Saturday, I've always put on West Brom 1-0 win. It paid off many, many times.
They've done the homework before they came here. On this pitch, you must have at least 7 or 8 players behind the ball. Fitzsimmons has slowed down even more. Pretty cool customer. He's really taking his time before he launches this one.
Launched it deep into the Linscore half, and been very impressed with the Wright Robinson College captain so far. Right, has played a captain's innings.
Kept it tight for them, and that's all they needed. But just looking more and more as Robinson College come into this, and the individual ability they've got up front probably backs them to get at least a goal, and it might only be that the one goal that decides this game.
Well, just as I said, looking at the results that we've seen from the last couple of days, if you like both teams to score, you'd be cashing in, right? I think there's only been 2 blanks that we've seen though, both on Monday. We've had a 5-1, a 4-3, a 1-1, a 2-1, a 3-1, a 5-1, a 7-1. So, expect a lot more goals, but these two teams have been keeping it tight, and that's...
Looking across the back line from Robinson College, they've got 4 versus 1. So, you know, I'm talking about Glyn College players behind the ball. Both sides are trying to nullify each other.
There's an opportunity knocks here for Glyn score with Thornburn. Thornburn stopped in his tracks.
Just tried a little crow to get away from his man, which was successful, but unfortunately the ball didn't have enough space. Went out for a throw in anyway.
As we have 12 minutes gone, so still got plenty of time here. Hoping it's going to get right back into this tie. The target's to aim for here. Tracks. I think it was a point-blank save. Couldn't really tell from our position, but it's another corner coming in, and once again trying to take the same thing, and it's going to be cleared from Gaia. Still in play for the team in blue, intercepted this time by Mafolo. Mafolo. Harley. Harley trying to send this one forward. Mafolo tries to chase, and he wins that race. Only momentarily, instead, it is kicked out of play by Chowdhury.
Chowdhury, yeah, he's worked back to try and defend properly. Here's the corner, here's the chance from the corner again. Swung into that near post area, and then it was a little flick initially. Can't see who got that touch. Was it Chowdhury? And the keeper with bodies around him just couldn't see a thing. I don't know how he's managed to. Was the defender on the line? Who's that number? McKenzie Yates on the line.
McKenzie Yates on the line, so it's a save on the line from Yates. to keep this game at 1-0 to the team in red. It's a Chris Gill, I believe, has just entered the field of play. Plenty of time here for both of these sides. Can't really get into this now, Gilly.
Great tackle to win the ball, but just to taking a little bit of care to make sure that you carry on with that movement. You had good momentum, and you know, Wright Robinson have got energy, but just that final pass has let them down at times. Play. There's been some outstanding performances today. There's, you know, there's a couple of players who will be going into the little competition for man of the match. There's plenty to choose from.
And it's out on both sides. Yes, Delhi and I will be sending our nominations forward for that, for the Twitter poll to take place in about 10 minutes or so from now. To Wright Robinson College. Nudge forward, keep it under pressure, and in! Well, well, well.
That looks like Mackenzie.
Mackenzie Yates indeed. He was here at one end and now here at the other.
He's gone for that near post. I think a lot of the corners haven't really been deeper and into the box at near post corner, looking for a flick or some kind of touch to trouble the goalkeeper. It's gone straight in. The goalkeeper, players surrounding him, I think, lost the flight of the ball, and in the end, all he could do was palm it into his own net. We saw earlier in the game where we were talking about goalkeepers maybe trying to catch it or whatever. You've got to palm it. A lot of goalkeepers, instead of, even it might look easy, they'll more punch or palm the ball out of danger just to make sure, because it only takes a slip or a loss of sight of the flight of the ball and you end up with a mistake or goals like that.
So Glyn score now with an uphill battle with 20 minutes to go, trying to get back into the contest. They made it do so! Chris Gill, the man with the Alamo defending.
And Robinson College riding the luck a little bit there. It was a long, hopeful ball into the box. It was bouncing around and could have quite easily fallen to any Glyn scores, but luckily for them, it fell.
Chris Gill, the man who was saving the day. And it's at least three or four of them for today for Wright Robinson College.
Shards was causing problems so much in the first half. Back on the pitch. Robinson College cleared the ball into the seats there. I don't know if he's done it on purpose. Waste a little bit of time. I'm not joking.
School looking to try and find a way to get back into this tie. Still have time to get back into it as well. 20 minutes to go. There's a lot can happen.
First half, they put some really good pass moves together. And there's a couple of slide through balls that have set their players clear for one goal, but they seem to be lacking that sort of invention. I mean, I think think part of the problem is that they're playing a five at the back. It looks like three centre half and two wing backs, and they're 2-0 down. Just got to find a way to get more players forward.
Looking to add a third, nudging across, opportunity comes! Liam Wood, and that could have put the game to bed.
That was it. Great approach played by Mafolo. He's ridden a couple of challenges out wide there. First one, good strength, and then a little bit of luck, but he's got a Megs, and then, you know, lifted his head, picked out the cross, and at the back post, Liam Wood just couldn't direct his head on target. He went off earlier, but he's definitely had something to Robinson College attack.
20 minutes to go. Glyn score, looking to get back into the contest. Annals of time to do so. Another goal here makes this game interesting. And now you see that Glyn score, knowing they're 2-0 down, they're trying to get back onto the front foot now and saying to themselves, we might lose 4-5 in a final. Just trying to get one more goal back into this game. All of a sudden, the momentum could shift.
Yeah, with so much time, they're probably slightly wrong approach. It seems just launching balls into the box, where they're a very good passing side, and they've got most of their joy by playing through lines and trying to break down Robinson College. But they've gone away a little bit from what was giving them a little bit of success in the first half.
Under pressure here from Robinson College, who look to try and put this game to bed.
Mackenzie Yates just pulling back, Salsing Chowdhury as he's about to sort of put one into the down the flank. Can you see? We've got a free kick and only two or three players in the opponent's box.
Liam Wood dancing his way down the left wing. Good tackle there from Tassim Chowdhury. He's an excellent game.
Yes, he really has done well. He has been calm and composed on the ball.
Good tackle, 10 on 10. This is Chris Gill. Fins our referee for a free kick, but he doesn't get no joy. Wishart.
There we are. Controlled possession from them. Just need to keep it moving. He's gone for a Hollywood ball there, when it would have been easy just to play it into someone's feet.
Gill. Chowdhury dispossesses right round to number 12. So it's picked up by Mafolo.
More and more dangerous as this game's gone on.
Cameron Duff. Kenzie Yates, he's had a good second half. Duff launched it from deep. And that's just wide of the upright. And still Wright Robinson College, two goals to the good.
I think Wright Robinson College, a lot of their strength is in their forward areas, just getting the ball into their forwards, and they're going to work, really.
Banjing and all in the crowd here today. Center circle. Glyn Is it Kieran Lilly? Lilly, Richard tries to put him under pressure. Picked up by Max Howard. Chowdhury, thunderously coming in like a train. There's no stopping him on that occasion. Duff trying to advance his many way towards a shot. Instead, it doesn't happen. And Chris Gill goes from distance and goes wide of the uprights. A little break of play. Danny, we might as well say to our audience, we've got some nominees for our player of the match. Let's run you through the nominees on the Twitter Schools Football. At Schools Football is where you can vote for the four nominees that which we have, and we'll announce the winner 15 minutes. Yeah, 15 minutes to vote, and we'll announce the winner towards the end. For Glyn School, we'd like to Tessie Chowdhury and Ryan Wishart.
Yeah, the two of them being industrious. Chowdhury gets on it as being calm and collected on the ball and really made Glyn School tick. And then Ryan Wishart, while he's been on the pitch, he's been industrious, willing to run in behind, and you know, has been a real threat.
And for Wright Robinson College, very briefly, because we have a free kick in a dangerous position here for Mackenzie Yates, Schaefer Simmons and KS Smart Powell.
Yeah, Simmons has been a rock, hasn't he? And then you've got Smart Powell, scored the goal and has been a threat all game. But I'd like to mention Mofolo, who's come more into it, but unfortunately just misses out.
Mackenzie Yates here, right at the keeper. And he could have had a nominee as well. He's had a very good second half as the Wright Robinson number 8. But there are your nominees. It is Tessie Chowdhury and Ryan Wishart, Glyn School. And it is KS Mark Powell and Shay Fitzsimmons of Wright Robinson College. At Schools Football on Twitter, they can vote for their player of the match on there. And we'll let you know, the votes will be live shortly. In the meantime, Glyn School looking to find a way back into the contest, and the door keeps slamming shut for them.
Whenever the ball that goes into Wishart, he's involved in a lot of more stable attacks. It's not able to. There's just not a lot of support. There's a lot of players in that back line for Glyn School still.
Cameron Duff. Ian Wood. Wishart. Course long shot by Pete Lass, who's another player for Wright Robinson College. Is that a good game?
Yeah, you know, him and Fitzsimmons have been excellent at the back there. Been a couple of opportunities where they've been tested, balls in behind them, but all the key elements, heading and kicking it for centre halves, they've done with a block, and being calm and collected on the ball in possession as well. Forward, still got two plays back in school, which you know,
Buckley to send this one in. A decent one it is as well. No head on it.
Lovely cross from Buckley, just like you said, no one can get that.
Oh, thunderous hit there from Wes Brown. To the team in red. Fitzsimmons telling this team to go forward, and they've caught them off guard here. Fast asleep were some of the Glyn School defenders, but there's no men forward for Wright Robinson College. Shay Fitzsimmons too smart for his own good, he says.
good work there. Mackenzie Yates has been industrious, he's there on the ball. It's a nice little bit of play. Trying to find the follow as often as they can. And he's actually one on one. Just wondering what he's going to try and do here. He's taking him on. Can he get a cross in?
Oh, he's a shot away. He said he goes for Chris Gill and goes some distance. Buckley tries to find an option.
Davis again, cleaning up.
Offside defending from number five. The no men forward again for Glyn School. Instead picked up by Captain Duff. Duff inside to Jallo, who's just come onto the field.
Welcome to the game. It's a hefty challenge there, but
so 10 minutes left to play. Reminder of our player of the match poll on Twitter at Schools Football. Pick your favourite for the player of the match. And Mafolo tries to go for a shot and spins away. Howard tries to find an option, says it goes high into the air, but it is picked up well by Oliver Buckley. Buckley tries to support Fitzsimmons under pressure for the first time in this match that we've seen. Wishart has got into the box. Excellent tackle by Pilas. Great tackle, and also tries to launch the counter-attack forward. Duff Mafolo is there. The baller, can he get a shot away? On a cross in, he goes at the cross, straight at the keeper.
This is what he's shooting on a cross in there, but that ball into Mafolo didn't have enough purchase to go send him through clear on goal, but he caused enough problems with the two defenders that it ran through for him.
Buckley. Pass goes through to Josh Guyon, and it seems that Leo Thornburn has been pulled up here. I think he might have pulled a hamstring. Not been spotted by the benches yet, but I think they might be coming off shortly. He seems to have had a little bit of a niggle. He's trying to run it off.
Anticipated that ball in behind him, was there to clear up the danger before it got to a dangerous point.
Gill. Opportunity knocks. Well, that's going to be a free kick.
Bunker showed really good feet all game. With the ball, he's really attacked this Robertson College defence, and there he was again with a weaving run. I think Mackenzie Yates wasn't going to allow him to go through again and brought him down right on the edge of the box.
Look at Merzelkin on the field, Val Munger going off.
Opportunity for Mazel to come on and show what he can do. He's taking up a central position. Just wondering if he's going to drift out wide.
Leo Thornburn coming off. Number seven. Ben O'Sullivan on the field, wearing number 7 Leo Thorburn shirt, so just to confuse the commentators, but I did warn you that at the start. He is the goalkeeper and outfield player. In the meantime, though, we got free kick, dangerous position taken over the bar.
Oliver Buckley, his technique's been sound all game, he'd be disappointed with himself there. Simmons is, a free kick, just let back. too much power.
Oh dear. It's okay though, there's not much danger. But we've seen that a couple of times, that the bobble of the ground has caused Glyn School a little bit of trouble.
As Powell went up for the head, I was thinking, oh, someone just gambled on that. And Jallo was there, but just not close enough to capitalise on the second mistake from the keeper, who's completely missed his clearance.
And follow. Goes to ground, free kick given.
I was just wondering why we haven't put him a follow. He's one of the men who come to his own second half. But you know, it's about the whole game and actually consistency throughout the whole game. There's been players who've featured up all the way through.
Cross coming in and wide of the final post. 5 minutes to go. Wright Robinson still 2 goals to the goal.
Jallo again, he's getting in amongst the action. He's announced his entrance into the game with a couple of opportunities.
He's been knocking them on the door, hopping and popping, but he just can't blow the house down at the minute.
Yeah, he was deployed in a wide position and he's caused plenty of problems, but you can see his pace and tenacity. He hasn't given up on anything. It's causing problems of its own, so if they can get the ball into him, I'm just wondering, with 5 or 6 minutes left, can he get himself on the score sheet?
Sean McNicholas on the field for Glyn School, as we've got... This is Chowdhury just receiving some treatment on the rubbing the at his calf. So we'll have a couple of minutes stoppage here as one or two players head to the touchline to get a little bit of water.
Must be serious if he's gone down there. 2-0 down, with only a couple of minutes left. They'll want to be getting this game back up and running as quickly as possible.
Football for the vote for the player of the match. He voted for the 4 nominees. Tasif Chowdhury, Ryan Wishart of Glyn School, Shaker Simmons and Pierce Smart Powell of Wright Robinson College. That vote is live and probably closing in the next few minutes. So we're approaching the end of this first game of 5 that we're bringing to you here on this Wednesday afternoon. Till around 7 o'clock tonight. That's right, Robinson College will be on the pitch again. They have a monopoly of the Hawthorns the first 3 games here today. Taking on Surbiton High School in the School's Cup for Girls, 14 Girls National Final. Glyn scored in the meantime, trying to get on the score sheet instead of a grandstand finish. Richard. Simmons with the head again. Trying to get a shot away. Instead, finds a red wall.
Well done, Richard. Again, he's just powered back there.
Says go alone and just wide.
It's a good move from Cameron Duff there, show a change of pace to get away from a couple of players and got around the edge of the box, and you know, you can't blame him for taking that shot off.
Bring that down.
Free kick to Glyn score. About a minute to go.
The crowd of players, you've always got to applaud the player who tries to bring it down and get the ball on the deck and play from there. Mufolo has worked really hard out wide in wide positions, and you know, as a centre forward as well, he's caused his own problems. Good hold up play.
30 seconds left. Touch sees that ball go out of play, and Glyn score with the throw. But the likelihood is this under 15 V team. This trophy's going to be heading up to Manchester.
Opportunity for Glyn. Score to launch one into the box. Got almost everyone up now. In fact, they have sent up one up off the goalkeeper and the table.
Goes low into the mixer and goes nowhere, and our referee Trevor Parks calls the end of that game, and here's the celebrations for Wright Robinson College. Congratulations to Wright Robinson College, who defeated Glyn School in this Scores Cup for B Teams national final for under 15s. They have defeated Glyn School by 2 goals to nil. Congratulations, Wright Robinson College.
Wright Robinson College, deserved winners, I think, over the balance of play for the games. Glyn School had a number of decent opportunities, but just couldn't find that finish that would have put them in the ascendancy.
So preparations have been made for the presentation, which is due to take place a few moments from now. But there is the confirmation of the results. Glyn School 0, Wright Robinson College 2 in this under 15 Schools Cup for B teams here at the Hawthorns. So this is the first goal.
As Powell anticipated that loose ball, the mistake from the defender. What an excellent finish. You know, he takes his eye, lifts his eyes up, and then just places it outside of his left foot, past the goalkeeper into the far net. Didn't think there was any danger at that point, but defender, error there. Just gone through his legs.
It's the goal, yeah, goal line clearance that we had early part of the second half. Kenji Yates is the man on the line.
Kenji Yates done ever so well to clear that. Just put his body in front of it. Managed to clear, scramble it away from goal. Not sure where the initial touch came from, but it's fortunate that he had him in that position.
And this is the second goal, Delhi, all from the corner.
Yeah, keeper's come out to claim, and then I'm not sure if he's trying to palm it over the crossbar, but, you know, just palm it outwards. He should have done all if he's trying to catch it. But only managed to palm it into the back of his net.
I think one thing we must say there for the Glyn School, if we can see that replay again from our director, look where the ball was situated on the side of that corner, by the way. It wasn't in the triangle. So it's only just that, only just his second spotted, in fact. So Wright Robinson College got away with one there, must be said.
Yeah, you know what? These things happen. We talked about VAR yesterday.
There you go, Delhi. Wow. By a foot.
It's not even close, is it? I wonder if he planned that.
Well, there you go.
But he still would have won 1-0 if that was a choke up.
But it's like Robertson College who gets the first victory here on day three.
Signing autographs.
Absolutely. But you had a good game, Kieran Lilly, and to be fair, the Wright Robinson College team all had a good game. Let's have a couple of notables over for Glyn School. Tessie Chowdhury, as we thought, was excellent. Ryan Wishart, Oliver Buckley, Liam Thorpe. The front line seemed to be creating chances, creating issues for the back line. But on the reverse of that, Wright Robinson College, Shaver, so it's excellent. John Pilas as well, we thought, was had an excellent second half.
Yeah, you know, there were some really good performances out there. Pilas was solid next to Fitzsimmons. The two of them marshalled their back line really well. But I thought, you know, the pick of them, actually looking back at it, Mofolo caused so many problems. More second half than first. First half, really, Robinson College couldn't get their game together.
Yeah, if there was a nominee for player of the match, we didn't put the send forward for the four that we did. Joe Mofolo, I think, was one there. I think he got better as the game went on.
Yeah, Powell was consistent. He was leading the line. He was taking all the kicks and blows and causing problems, and was there throughout the game. A little bit more of a consistent performance, but Mofolo was running the show second half. And when he got on the ball, he was causing problems down that right flank. And then when he went up front, you know, held the ball up well as well too. You know, I'd like to mention Glyn School, Ryan Wishart, who is one of the nominees. You know, was industrious, put himself about when the ball, he kept it really well for Glyn School, and I thought silently had a really good game. This time round, and they've lost in this, but they can go with their heads held high. they are the better of the first half.
No, absolutely. You know, with respect, compared to some of the results that we've seen here over the last few days, and there's been a couple of one-sided affairs. And then Glyn score, well, you feel, you know, for much of this game, we're well in it, and they could have been on another day 4-5-0 up.
Yeah, if you look at one of the goals, was not in the corner flag, and then the other goal was a defensive mistake. It's two errors that have cost them today, you know. But I think the biggest problem that they had was they were sat too deep, too many plays behind the ball. They never really committed plays forward.
Well, just been announced, Tassif Chowdhury is the player of the match.
Oh, I think he deserved it, especially first off. He settled down Glyn School, so a lot of the football that they played was down to him getting his foot on the ball, just keeping the play ball, recycling it across the pitch, because it was getting a very scrappy and very end-to-end, and he definitely was a standout player who got his team passing the ball.
So a consolation prize for Tassif Chowdhury, who goes away with the player of the match medal. And Glyn School will now receive their runners-up medals. Congratulations to Glyn School, who take the runners-up medals in this under-15s B team final here at the ESFA PlayStation FC Schools Cup final for 2022. Robinson College collecting their winners' medals. After taking this first final on this third day of the Schools Cup Finals Festival here at the Hawthorns by 2-0. And it will be the captain, Shea Fitzsimmons of Wright Robinson College. Who picks up the under-15s Schools Cup for B teams here at the Hawthorns. He's itching to celebrate with it. And now going to run over to his side. Shea Fitzsimmons and Wright Robinson College, the winners. On the PlayStation FC Under-15 Schools Cup for B teams, Wright Robinson College, many congratulations to you. The winners of the opening match here on the third day. On the PlayStation Schools Cup Festival here for 2022. Coming up next, we have the under-14 teams Schools Cup final for girls national final. Wright Robinson College again against Surbiton High School. That kicks off in around 15 minutes from now.
So I'm here with Coach Nathan from Glyn School. It just wasn't meant to be today.
Listen, we turned up today. We wanted to give it our all. I can't really ask anything more of my players. They came out today. They left it all on the pitch. And honestly, I couldn't be proud of that.
That's a key thing. They really didn't give up until those final few moments. They were there right to that final whistle.
Yeah, the spirit in the squad runs all the way from back to front. They honestly are a sensational group of lads. And honestly, I'm so proud of them.
I think that spirit, it's safe to say, runs through to the crowd as well. It's one of the most vocal crowds we've had so far at the Schools Cup.
Listen, the crowd have done themselves justice today. They were absolute heroes. Every single person didn't stop singing from minute one. And honestly, I can't thank them for the support that they've shown after that score.
One more time, let's hear it for Glyn School! So before we hear our next team manager meeting, we do have a lost phone with us, which looks like a phone, very nice indeed. Come and see our stewards. I'm sure that they'll be able to place it with its rightful owner in just a few moments' time as we catch up with Kieran Gee from Wright Robertson College next. So I'm here with Coach Kieran from Wright Robinson. It was a really great final between the two sides, really backing it out.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's a great day, isn't it? Getting the opportunity to play something like this is once in a lifetime, I suppose. But, you know, credit to Glyn School, made a good game of that.
Absolutely, there were definitely a sense of occasion, and your players really did step up to the plate in that final. They really made themselves noticed.
They've been doing that all year, you know, we've had a real tough draw, but quite an extensive league campaign as well, so, you know, it just keeps surprising me, you know, but I really eye on the next season now, that's the thing.
That's it, next season still to come after a long season, this one. How proud are you of all these guys on the pitch?
Like, unbelievable, you know, I've said it since day one, I wouldn't want to take another bunch of lads through this, it's cliche, but every one of them to a man, you know, unbelievable. It's a few lads who come here today as well, for various reasons, injuries and squad.
Well, you know what? I'll let you go and celebrate with your team one more time. Let's hear it for Wright Robinson College. So once again, Hawthorns, we do have a lost phone that's been given in to our stewards, a lost phone. So if you are missing a phone, make yourself known to our stewards team, and I'm sure we can place it back with its rightful owner.